My name is Robin Foster. I'm the 8th grade science teacher at ILTexas in Garland, and this is Checksum. He is a mossy-leaf tail gecko. The species originates in Madagascar. Madagascar used to be covered with forests. Sadly, they're down to about 97% have been developed or are farmland now, and only 3% remains as forest. This little guy's relatives are actually hunted by poachers. So they go out in the wild and they catch the Europlatysicerae, the mossy leaf tail gecko, and they sell them. This guy was not one of those. He was actually purchased captive bred. Now, I got him at the DFW Reptarium, which is located in Plano, and they have really expert employees. So I was looking for a classroom pet that wouldn't be too distracting, but would have a story of its own. So his species don't have very many individuals left. So with the crested gecko, a different species of gecko that I also have in my classroom, they were actually thought to be extinct. They were discovered in 1866 and then rediscovered in 1994 because they like to hide in foliage and people thought they had disappeared. This guy has such amazing camo that when he sits on a bark or a twig, he changes his colors and he looks and feels rough and he flattens himself out, so he just almost completely disappears. I've had students come in the room and tell me, "Miss Foster, the geckos are gone." And I have to point and say, "Okay, look for his eyes. There he is." Because that's how amazing this guy's camo is. These guys are also known as the flat-tail gecko because they will dangle from a branch and their tail will curl under and actually get little ridges to it, so it will look like a dead leaf. Hence the name Mossy Leaf Tail Gecko. So he's part of the family of flat tail geckos. I have a male and a female. I was lucky enough to locate that pair, and DFW was kind enough to give me a little discount on purchasing them. So I've had them here over a year now, and we have just recently gotten eggs. So the first few eggs that the female laid, her name is Parity, they were dud eggs, and apparently that's pretty normal. So we knew they were duds because they collapsed almost immediately. So we have very carefully, we have 4 eggs total. Geckos lay eggs in pairs. So we have 1 egg in the Frappuccino containers, and then 1 container contains 2 eggs. What I'm trying to do is encourage people to breed the Europlatysicerae so that the poachers won't make any profit off of pulling them out of the wild. Captive bred geckos have a tendency to live a lot longer than a wild caught gecko, but if you search on the internet, you can find they're still available even now. As you can see, they're easy to handle. They have no teeth and no claws. They do have the little sticky toes, and they're not sticky as in a substance, but there's actually teeny tiny hairs. And if you look up the van der Waals attraction, you'll have an idea how gecko feet work. They're actually researchers going over how gecko feet work with the possibility of developing special gloves that help people keep a grip on things like golf clubs and other sports equipment, as well as possible military applications. So what I have here, they are slightly a bit more challenging to care for than, say, the crested gecko. They eat crickets, which I purchase at the local pet shop or at DFW, and they stay in this container here. And then the crickets like the dark, so they actually crawl up inside the tubes, and I just pull the tube out and shake them into the enclosure. Now sometimes I shake and bake the crickets, that's what the students call it. I have a little vitamins in a bag, and it coats the crickets. Since the female is laying eggs, we want her to have enough calcium and vitamins in her diet so that it doesn't hurt her health. And this little guy is arboreal, which means he likes to climb higher up in the tree. That makes him feel a little bit safer. And I'm thinking that's why he's doing this now. So I provide different sticks and artificial plants so that he can crawl up in around in his enclosure. I have a fogger that is set up with a hygrometer. So there's a sensor inside that tells what the humidity is for that environment. I set it to a specific humidity. If the humidity drops below a certain level, the fogger comes on and then adds water vapor to the enclosure to keep it at an optimal humidity for the Europlatosicori. This little guy has been handled a lot. He's very mellow, so he's very used to it. If you have a gecko that's not used to being handled, you just start by touching it, letting him know that you're not a threat, and then slowly working into where he can be held. Most of the time, the students in my classroom will end up holding the crested gecko just because they're even easier to handle. And this little guy can be a little skittish. They do jump. So part of the reason it's so important to get captive breeders for this particular reptile is the habitat loss is actually threatening the species. We don't have a specific number of these geckos that are left in the wild because it's so hard to even see them, much less count them. The government of Madagascar just recently has made it a crime to collect them, but they're not really enforcing that. So the challenge is getting the species where it will survive and where you have sufficient diversity that you're not breeding too close to the same line. And this is Splat, the crested gecko that I mentioned earlier. Part of the reason that I have animals in my classroom is you never know what's going to inspire one of the students. One of the reasons that I teach science is that I wanted to give back. I wanted to help my students understand how many possibilities there are in the world, how many different things science covers, and how to think in a way that's scientific, and that means a good thing, not a bad thing. So there are so many problems that we have in the world, whether it's deforestation in Madagascar or a species going extinct. Every bit of that changes how our world works. This gives those students the opportunity to change the world for the better, to invent something that will help with the reforestation, that will help use something else so that something damaging to the environment isn't necessary. So this is my chance to help out, and the geckos are part of my team.